हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द न्यू लेक्चर सेशन। टुडे विल डिस्कस द कंपैरिजन बिटवीन द ऑटोमोबाइल एंड द अर्थ मूविंग मशीन। मायसेल्फ शंखु घोष, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ ऑटोमोबाइल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट डॉक्टर सुधीर चंद्र सोन डिग्री इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अंडर द GIS ग्रुप। एज आई टोल्ड, द टॉपिक ऑफ टुडे इज द कंपैरिजन बिटवीन ऑटोमोबाइल एंड द अर्थ मूविंग मशीन। दिस टॉपिक इज टेकन फ्रॉम द मॉड्यूल नंबर 1 व्हिच इज अर्थ मूविंग इक्विपमेंट्स। एंड दिस टॉपिक collected from the subject which is known as earth moving equipments and the farm machinery. This subject is taken from the third year 7th semester diploma in automobile engineering student syllabus. So students, before starting this today's class, in the previous classes we already discuss the introduction of the earth moving equipments and the farm machinery. Then we discuss the various types of the earth moving equipments and its function, and we also discuss the general specification of this typical earth moving machine. And now today we'll discuss the comparison between automobile and earth moving machine. So student, let's start the today's class. Start with this operating condition. Machines are required to serve. The machines are required to serve in different working situation and working condition also. So these are the demanded. These are demanded by the user of the machine and the plants. So basically, the requirement of the machines to serve in different working situation or and working condition, these are the demanded by the user of the machines and the plants. So for that reason, the designer and the manufacturers follow the requirements and make such provision during the design and the manufacture. Supposing the requirement was placed by a transport company to automobile manufacturer to make and supply 50 jeeps which is capable to move in muddy, snowy, slippery roads of hilly, rich and having rains. So naturally, the manufacturer of the automobile product will be compact, strong, powerful, four-wheel drive, light motor vehicle of cross-country capacity they can used. Such as example, if the requirement was placed by a transport company to an automobile manufacturer that to make and supply 50 jeeps, those are capable to move in muddy, snowy, slippery roads of hilly, rich and having the gradients. So naturally, the manufacturers or the designer of the automobile products, they are try to design and manufacturing according to this requirement, and they produce and the automobile product will be the compact, strong, powerful four-wheel drive. If any bulldozer is needed to work in above condition, it will definitely be a crawler mounted. So in case of jeep, if any kind of bulldozer is needed for this purpose, means which moves in the muddy, snowy, slippery roads of hilly, rich and having the gradient, for this purpose the bulldozer is needed to work in this condition, and it will be definitely be used the crawler mounted. color mountain they used. So any type of automobile, so therefore the any types of automobile and the heavy or the farm equipments are made and supposed to work all over our country, it should be conducted to work in between the extreme temperature and the humidity range, number 2 extreme altitude ranges, and number 3 extreme track conditions, etc. So any kinds of automobile and the heavy or the farm equipments, those are made for all are made and supposed to work and made and supposed to work all over the country, so it should be work in this condition. The condition, those conditions are, first one is the extreme, it has to be work under the extreme temperature and the extreme humidity ranges. It has to be worked extreme altitude ranges, and it has to be work in the extreme track conditions. So these are the condition to designer have to be replaced during their design. Just as example, when a truck will be loaded, when a truck will be loaded at Jodhpur of Rajasthan, and it carry some material up to Ladakh. So that truck will be covered in the desert to the cold higher altitude. So when a truck is loaded some kind of material or carry some material from Jaipur to the Ladakh, so this truck have try to cover in the desert, which is a hot higher altitude, to the Ladakh, which one is the cold higher altitude. So for this reason, the designer try to design with this function condition in your head. Those are this extreme temperature working condition in the extreme temperature and the extreme humidity ranges, extreme altitude ranges, and extreme track condition. Now, the working environment of automobile. The working environment of automotive or the environment of the automotive vehicles are partly standardized as they move on the metal road. The working road speed of the vehicles now even crossed engine speed by applying the overdrive. So this truck standard helped to manufacture number 1 tread of tire and B suspension system. So when an automotive vehicle is working in its environment, they have to partly standardized as they move on the metal road. So as when the working road speed of the vehicles even cross the engine speed by applying the overdrive, so this track standard help to manufacture the tread of the tire, that is the first one, and second one is the suspension system. So these are the most important things. So in case of this heavy equipment and the farm machine, so these are the condition is applied on the automotive vehicle. Now coming to the heavy equipment and the farm machinery. So in case of heavy equipment and the farm machinery, the working environment of machines, the working environment of the machines are not predetermined and the standardized, which is required for the automotive vehicles. So special design, manufacturer and maintenance measures the special design, manufacture and maintenance measures are adapted to suit them for the different working condition. So for the different kind working condition, they have to design a need to a special design, specially manufacture, and the special way to maintenance of the heavy equipments and the farm machineries. This is example, a drag line. It may be worked on sandy soil and it may be worked under the water operation. So for when a drag line is worked on sandy soil, so there for that time they have to different kind of design, different kind of manufacture, and different kind of maintenance. And when the drag line is used under the water operation, they have a different kinds of design, differently manufacture, and different types of the maintenance. So for this reasons heavy vehicles or earth moving machine and the farm machinery, they are required their special design, specially manufacture, and the maintenance measurement in the variant working condition. A counsel can be used to work for the digging well. And equality, it can be used for to transfer the iron ingot. So a counsel can be used to work digging the well, and equality, it can be used for the transfer the iron ingot. A farm tractor can be used for tillage or transporting the load like a truck. So therefore to serve the interest of the user, the art of making of the heavy equipments are more versatile in nature, and which is compared to the automobile. So when we try to design a farm machinery or the earth moving machine, we need to understand the using of the users and to serve the interest of the user, and after that the art of making of this heavy equipment. So that's why the art of making of heavy equipments are more versatile in nature compared to the automobile. Now coming to the traveling speed. Automobiles are to cover the distance at a faster rate, and its coverage of distance should be safe and efficient. So these are the primary object of the automobile. So covering a distance at a faster way, and covering a distance that should be safe and efficient. So these are the primary objects of an automobile. Where the earth moving machines with collection and displacement of soil, boulders, rocks, and minerals is their primary object, and coverage of distance is the secondary object. So student, as the distance covering at a fast rate and that should be safe and efficient, these are the primary object of an automobile, where the earth moving machines, the primary object of the earth moving machines is with collection and the displacement of the soil, boulders, rocks, and minerals. These are the primary objects, and distance covering is the secondary object. So therefore the traveling speed of the automobiles is higher compared to the speed of the earth moving machine. So this is the simple things in case of the traveling speed. Just because of it is used, automobile is used for the traveling purpose or to covering a distance. So that's why it has to be higher speed compared to the earth moving machinery and the farm machinery. Now compared to this for automobile and the for earth moving machines, heavy earth moving machines. For the heavy earth moving machines, the highest road speed at tractor is that is 1 to 15 km per hour. So this is the highest road speed of a tractor. Working speed of a drag line during the operation, that is 60 meter per hour only. So these are the working speed of a drag line which is during the operation. The operational speed of a crawler mounted tipper on level track, that is 2.4 meter per minute. So these are the speed range of a heavy earth moving machines. So in case of automobile, so automobiles are wheel mounted and mostly using the radial tires. So it has the designation using the few letters. Those letters are S, H and V. So these letters means S, H and V. These letters are expressed the speeding rate of the vehicle. So where S express the speed up to 170 km per hour, H express speed up to 210 km per hour, and V expressed speed up to 210 km per hour. So these are the speed range of this using letters on the designated in the tire. So therefore the representative speed of the automobile, that is 200 kilometer per hour. So in case of the modern light motor vehicle uses overdrive, which reduces the average engine speed up to 20 to 25%, and it increasing the road speed more than the engine. So these are the basically speed of the automobile. Now coming to the traveling speed, the traveling speed of automobile is nearly 10 times higher, approximately 10 times higher than heavy earth moving machines. So for this, what are the reasons for this? Number one is working outlook of automobile. The working outlook of automobile is only coverage of distance in a safe and efficient manner. And in case of the heavy earth moving machine, the outlook is this distance covering outlook is the secondary purpose. Number two, the torque multiplication in the driving wheel. The torque multiplication in the driving wheel is more for the heavy earth moving machine, whereas it is mostly 2 points or it may be single point in case of the automobile. Number three, the heavy earth moving machines use heavy power plants with the capacity of 4 times or more than automobile, the automobile. So only minor part of this power, so only minor part of this power is used for the traction only. So on the other hand, it is used for crowding, loading, unloading, hoisting, swinging, and dumping loads, which are the primary function of these kinds of machines. So it is not essential to operate the heavy earth moving machine with the high travel speed to maintain their efficiency. Hence, they are made to operate with the lower speed, travel speed of automobile. Most of the heavy earth moving machines are crawler mounted, which doesn't permit the higher travel speed. So most of the heavy earth moving machines are crawler mounted, so those are not permitted the higher travel speed. So now coming to the next, that is power output and the power variation with the torque variation. The brake power of an IC engine means the power which is available at the crankshaft. This is called the brake power. So brake power of an IC engine is usually the brake power of an IC engine is usually measured by means of brake mechanism, and the equation is BP, or the brake power, equals to 2 pi nt by 60, and the unit of the brake power, that is watt. And when we multiply 1000 with the 60, and the equation looks like two pi nt by sixty into 1000, then the brake power unit should be kilo watt. So these are the equation of the brake power. Next is the torque. Torque is a rotating force which is produced by an engine's crankshaft. So by an engine's crankshaft, the rotating force is the force which is produced by the rotating of the engine's crankshaft is called as the torque. And the more torque of an engine produces, the greater its ability to perform the work. And the equation is TE equals to BP into 60 divided by 2 pi ME, and the unit is Newton meter. Here TE means torque of engine, and NE means engine speed in RPM. So from this equation, So from this equation, when the brake power is constant, when the brake power is constant, then torque is inversely proportional to the engine speed. So students, from here we got the torque produced by the engine, the torque which is produced by the engine is inversely proportional, is inversely proportional to the RPM of the engine, frame of this engine. Now, so as I told, when the brake power is constant, when the brake power is constant, torque is inversely proportional with the engine speed. So from here we can state this, we can easily state that the torque of engine, the torque of the engine is inversely proportional to the speed of the engine. Now coming to the next one, where if the torque which is produced, if the torque is produced by the wheel, so that time the torque is denoted by the TW, and the speed of the wheel is denoted by NW. The reduction ratio of RPM, the reduction ratio of the RPM at gearbox denoted by G1, and reduction ratio of the RPM in differential which is denoted by the G2. So from here we can find out the these terms TW, NW, G1, G2, there's some relation. So the relation is that NW equals to NE into G1 and G2. NW means speed of the wheel, and NE means speed of the engine, and G1 means the reduction ratio of the RPM at the gearbox, and G2 is the reduction ratio of RPM at differential. So these are the gearbox reduction ratio, and this one is the differential box reduction ratio. And from here you can find out this equation where torque TW, because from here we can find out that N equals to NW by G1 into G2. So now from here we can got that torque of the wheel, is equals to 1 by G1 into G2 into TE, where torque of TW denotes the torque of the wheel, G1 is the denoted as the reduction ratio of gear reduction ratio at the gearbox, G2 means the gear reduction ratio at the gearbox, and TE is the torque of the engine. Here is the picture of flow of power for the wheel mounted tractor. So this one is the engine, this one is the clutch section, this is the gearbox section, here is the differential section, now here is the wheel. So, as we told here, the engine speed is denoted by the NE and torque of the engine is denoted by the TE. G1 is denoted by the gearbox reduction and G2 is denoted by the differential reduction and TW is the torque of the wheel, NW is the speed of the wheel. So from here, engine's power is produced inside the engine, then it is passes through the gearbox with the help of the clutch, then from the gearbox it is provided to the differential with the help of this popular shaft and the universal joints, and after that from this differential joint differential it power is transferred to the wheel, where the speed is of the wheel that is denoted by the NW and the torque of the wheel is denoted by the TW. So these are the power flow line of wheel mounted tractor. So students, here today we will cover, we start with the discussion of the differences of automobile and the heavy earth moving machine. So for this reason we are covering the travel speed of this, covering the few points. Those are traveling speed. Second one is we are discussed on power output and the power variation with the torque variation and the operative condition. And next, in the next class, we'll continue this torque variation during the working of the heavy earth moving machine. So till then, stay at home and stay safe. Thank you. Thank you so much, students.